Ladies and gentlemen, the President of the Republic of the Philippines, His Excellency Ferdinand R. Marcos Jr. and Vice President Sara Z. Duterte. May we now be seated. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the declaration of Davao as insurgency-free and relaunching of Davao region as a tourism and investment-ready destination. To formally begin our program, may we call on the officer in charge of the Department of National Defense, Senior Undersecretary Jose C. Faustino Jr., to deliver his message.
His Excellency Ferdinand Romualdo Marcos Jr., Vice President Inday Zara Duterte, Special Assistant to the President Antonio F. Lagdameo Jr., Governor Corazon Malanyaon of Davao Oriental, Mayor Sebastian Duterte, and Lieutenant General Greg Almirol, the Commander of Eastern Mindanao Command, other cabinet members present, local chief executives, fellow workers in government, good afternoon to everyone. As the officer in charge of the Department of National Defense, I am extremely honored and pleased to declare, pursuant to the Regional Peace and Order Council Resolution Number 7, dated October 12, 2022, that the entire Region 11, comprising of Davao del Norte, Davao del Sur, Davao de Oro, Davao Oriental, Davao Occidental, and City of Davao, as an insurgency-free region. Sa lahat ng nakiisa sa ating mga gawaing pangkapayapaan, maraming salamat po sa inyo. Ang makasaysayang tagumpay na ito ay isang patunay na kayang supilin ng sambayanang Pilipino ang anumang salot o banta sa kapayapaan at kaunlaran ng ating bayan. Mabuhay ang bawat Pilipino. Mabuhay ang bansang Pilipinas.
Thank you, Senior Undersecretary Faustino. At this juncture, may we call on the Regional Development Council 11 Chairperson and Governor of Davao Oriental, Governor Corazon Malanyaon, to deliver her message.
Our courtesies to His Excellency President Ferdinand R. Marcos Jr., our Honorable Vice President and Secretary of the Department of Education, Sara Z. Duterte, Secretary Erwin Tulfo, Secretary Manuel Bunuan, Senior Undersecretary of the Department of National Defense, Jose C. Faustino Jr., our Eastern Mindanao Commander, Lieutenant General Greg Almirol, our Special Assistant to the President, Anton Lagdameo, Mayor Sebastian Baste Duterte, Governor Edwin Ubahib, Governor Dorothy Gonzaga, Vice Governor Tyrone Uy, Congressman Nelson L. Dayanghirang of the 1st District of Davao Oriental, guests from the local government units, national government agencies and the private sector, colleagues in the Regional Development Council 11 and the Regional Peace and Order Council 11, our partners from the press, ladies and gentlemen, maayong hapon kanatong tanan. This is the third event on this momentous day with the two top leaders of our country in our midst. In 1976, several years after the CPP-NPA was established, the press reported an ambush incident in Davao Oriental which killed 7 people, including a Philippine Constabulary officer. The crime was perpetrated by armed rebels. It was a blunt realization that the CTG insurgency has reached Mindanao and the Davao region. From then on, Davao region became a hotbed of dissident activities and CPP-NPA atrocities. Davao region was a crucial center of operations of a protracted war between the government and the rebels. The number of lives lost and families displaced were great and saddening. The cost of the communist terrorist group's armed conflict has also been staggering, putting decades of development efforts on either a standstill or a major setback. Nothing, however, could permanently shackle Davao region from its path towards development as it harnessed the resiliency and hope of Davaoenos and the unyielding strength of its development institutions and its police and military forces to overcome the insurgency. Beginning in the fourth quarter of 2021, where the province of Davao del Sur was declared insurgency-free, followed by the provinces of Davao del Norte, Davao Occidental, Davao de Oro, and the city of Davao in June 2022, and finally by Davao Oriental on September 19, 2022. It is therefore appropriate that the Davao region, the entire Davao region, followed suit. This declaration has been 50 years in the making, which makes it all the more momentous. Despite being one of the country's consistent top-performing regional economies, with an average annual growth rate of 8% from 2016 to 2019, owed to the region's competitive advantages, Davao region suffered economic setbacks due to the pandemic with a 61% decline in registered investments and a 75% decrease in tourist arrivals in 2021. With the concerted efforts of public and private sector stakeholders, Davao region is on the road to recovery, as evidenced by the 5.9% growth in gross regional domestic product in 2021, remaining as Mindanao's largest economy, and with the influx of 1.047 million tourists during the first semester of 2022. With this, it is indeed an opportune time to relaunch our region as a tourism and investment-ready destination. After the declaration of the region as insurgency-free by no less than the Department of National Defense Senior Undersecretary Jose C. Faustino Jr., based on Regional Peace and Order Council 11 Resolution Number 07, implementary move, the Regional Development Council, or the RDC 11, through Executive Committee, EXCOM Resolution Number 43, Series of 2022, manifested Davao Region's preparedness as a tourism and investment-ready destination that shall reinforce the economic recovery efforts of all sectors and make it known to the rest of the country and the world what Davao region has to offer in terms of tourism and investments opportunities. These declarations are further bolstered by the President's face-to-face transactions in private and government operations, especially in the education and tourism sectors. In a nutshell, Davao Region fueled this relaunching by upscaling the industry cluster's roadmap, focusing on the 18 priority industries of the region. It is also notable that during the virtual conference of the RDC 11 on December 7, 2020, the Council approved the implementation of the updated Regional Tourism Development Plan 2020 and 2022 and Regional Farm Tourism's Strategic Action Plan for 2020 to 2023. This plan shall serve as our framework on the ways forward of Region 11 towards this momentous relaunching. Investments in Davao Region shall be primarily focused on our economic growth drivers for fast recovery and sustained progress for our people. In agribusiness, we shall promote more investments in our established agri-industries in cacao, coffee, abaca, fruits and vegetables, and other high-value crops, and in aquaculture and marine fishery. Likewise, investments in manufacturing for both heavy and export-oriented light industries, also investments in research and development and innovation, ICT and telecommunications, in response to the fourth industrial revolution, which shall complement our needs for human capital for higher productivity in all sectors. In order to enhance trade for the local and international markets, our seaports shall be developed specially. The Sasa International Seaport, Santa Ana Wharf, and Matis City Wharf. For tourism, investments in more environment-friendly destinations like farm and ecotourism, including culture and heritage tourism, shall be promoted with the opening of new gateways and efficient transport systems. Another gateway shall be developed with the operationalization of the airport in the city of Mati to enhance tourism and investments in the northern part of Davao Region and all development of creative industries along its domains on audiovisual and digital interactive media, creative services and design, among others, shall be put forward to local and foreign investors. Tourism and investments in Davao Region shall be bolstered by the strong opening of the economy through trade policies, easing of travel restrictions, and more face-to-face interactions in private and government operations. We shall support the national government through a strong collaboration of all sectors and sustained local governance under strong and effective political leadership to ensure an inclusive economic recovery and sustainable progress for all. Davao Region commits to support the national government through a stronger collaboration of all sectors, sustained local economic recovery, and sustainable progress for all. Davao Region, more than ever, is now ready to welcome all visitors and investors. Dagang salamat o mabuhay.
Thank you, Governor Malanyaon.
I request everyone to please stand. Ladies and gentlemen, Please welcome with a round of applause the President of the Republic of the Philippines, Ferdinand Romualdez Marcos Jr.
Thank you very much, Vice President Sara Duterte. Please take your seats. The Oriental Governor and RDC Council Chairperson Corazon Malañon and other government officials of the province, my fellow workers in government, our men and women in uniform, ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon. What we celebrate today is the significant sectors that work together towards attaining peace and security in the Davao region. We must be all proud and happy, knowing that the Davao region has been declared as insurgency-free by the Davao Regional Peace and Order Council. An important day indeed. It's a victory which proves there is no place for extremism and senseless violence anywhere in the Philippines. We must, of course, acknowledge the efforts of our LGUs, our various government agencies and law enforcement authorities in the region for supporting the NTF-ELCAC by improving public safety and implementing programs that improve the living conditions for all. In many ways, the program NTF-ELCAC has been around for a long time in different forms. It was still always referred to in earlier than that. We used to call it in government civic action, from the military. But the MTF that was attached to the NTF-ELCAC was, I think, what brought us success, because instead of the they deal with the entire government and whatever it is that the government can give. That one is what we will gain the government. So to those men and women who were part of that very important effort, your patriotism, your sacrifice, your commitment to the ideals of peace have yielded successful and fruitful results. Now the people in the region, especially those in geographically responsible. And so I say this to our armed forces, that we must see these developments, that perhaps in a way we can say that the armed forces, the uniformed forces in our war fighters, now we ask you to be bringers of peace. And the success of the NTF-ELCAC program and all of the efforts of our military, of our police, insurgency-free. Moving forward, we take an optimistic but cautious step to mind that the goal of achieving long-lasting peace and order in the region cannot end just with this declaration. We will need to sustain it with the whole of nation over our countrymen. We cannot afford to go back to square one. Thus, I call on the armed forces, government agencies, LGUs, and communities to continue working together to celebrate this victory. I believe that there is no better way to commemorate the eradication of insurgency in Davao than to declare the region as a tourism and investment ready. We have relaunched Davao as a tourism and investment their destination. And I say that because, in truth, Davao, with its very up to better than the national averages, have always been there. However, we have always had to deal with the security problem that was holding progress back. So peace and progress, always an environment that is able to thrive and reach its full potential amidst our rapidly changing world. This declaration serves as a timely platform to one city. As Mindanao's largest economy, the Davao region will play an important role in this march of the entire country towards prosperity. It has also maintained its stature as a rich land. It is my hope that all the things you have achieved here in Davao can also be replicated across the country. This way, we can reproduce our shared success 100 generations to come. So, as we go forward into the new normal, let us continue working together to revitalize the economy. Great setbacks, as we all have. This brought about by the pandemic. We have seen more than 61% decline in registered investments and as much as 70% decrease in tourist arrival. Holders, I am confident that we can reverse that trend. And I think that upon hearing some of the briefings that I had earlier today, I think you already have been. And I think that we can say with a greater level of confidence that we have heard count promise. Thank you and good afternoon.
Kindly grant us a photo opportunity in two batches. For batch one, may we call on the regional director. Batch two, please prepare. Batch two, please prepare. Our joint task force and infantry brigade commanders. Our joint task force and infantry brigade commanders. And that concludes our program. Once again, ladies and gentlemen, His Excellency President Ferdinand R. Marcos Jr. Congratulations to the success of the Executive Committee of the Regional Peace and Order Council 11 and the Regional Development Council 11. Maing hapon